Okay, guys, for this second part of the heart, let's go over more details. Let's get started with the right coronary artery. So if you recall, the coronary arteries supply the cardiac muscle with oxygenated blood, and then the coronary veins are draining the heart muscle, and then they put that blood back into the right atrium. So we're going to get started with the right coronary artery. And so here it is, that's the right coronary artery. This one originates from the right aortic sinus here on the aorta, and it descends. Let me go back to the right coronary artery. Here it is. And it descends in the coronary sulcus on the sternocostal surface. And it's going actually between the right atrium and the right ventricle. It turns around inferior on the inferior border of the heart, and it continues in the posterior part of the coronary sulcus towards its end, and it gives off the posterior interventricular artery, which is actually that one over there, and it runs in the posterior interventricular sulcus towards the apex. So some of the main branches include the sinoatrial nodal branch. So here is that one, that branch. It gives you the right marginal branch. Here it is, that's the right marginal. It gives you an atrioventricular nodal branch. I don't think that it's labeled here. And then it gives you also the posterior interventricular, which we already saw. So the right coronary artery, let me go back to it. The right coronary artery typically supplies most of the right ventricle. It also supplies a small part of the diaphragmatic surface of the left ventricle, the posterior one-third of the interventricular septum, the right atrium, of course, the interatrial septum, and the SA node and AV node as well. And of course, if we have a right, we must have a left. So here is the left coronary artery, which originates from the left aortic sinus, that's the aorta. And so this left coronary artery passes posterior to the pulmonary trunk, as you can observe right here, here's the pulmonary trunk. And that artery divides into two branches. It's gonna give you an anterior interventricular artery, also known as the left anterior descending, or LAD for short, and it gives you a circumflex artery or branch. In terms of the anterior interventricular artery, let me go back to it. This one descends towards the apex of the heart in the anterior interventricular sulcus, and it turns around on the inferior border of the heart and anastomoses with the terminal branches of the posterior interventricular artery, which is that one right there. And then in terms of the circumflex artery, let me go back to it. Circumflex artery curves around the left aspect of the heart in the coronary sulcus. It gives off these left marginal arteries and other terminal branches. And what they do is they anastomose with the terminal branches of the right coronary artery. And so the left coronary artery, let me go back to it. This artery typically supplies most of the left ventricle. It also supplies a small part of the right ventricle, the anterior two-thirds of the interventricular septum, and also the left atrium, the AV bundle, and its right and left bundle branches, as well as the SA node. Now, and also the AV node. Now, the only difference is that the right coronary artery, in terms of the SA node and the AV node, this one actually supplies to around 60% of the people and 80% of the people. And then for the left coronary artery, the SA node, it's going to be supplied by this artery in 40% of the people. And the AV node, it's going to be in 20% of the people. Now, for the venous drainage of the heart, most venous blood from the heart is collected by the coronary sinus, which is this structure right here posteriorly. And so the coronary sinus, it's located on the posterior side of the heart. So this one runs from the left to the right in posterior part of the coronary sulcus, and it drains into the right atrium, which is this structure right here. And there's going to be several tributaries of coronary sinus that are going to bring that blood from the heart into the coronary sinus and then, of course, into the right atrium. So the first one, it's the great cardiac vein on this anterior side of the heart. So the great cardiac vein ascends in the anterior interventricular sulcus with the anterior interventricular artery. And this one reaches the coronary sulcus. And when that happens, it turns left and it accompanies the circumflex artery and becomes continuous with the coronary sinus. There's also the middle cardiac vein, which is this one right here. And the middle cardiac vein runs in the posterior interventricular sulcus with the posterior interventricular artery. And there's also a small cardiac vein, which is this one right there. And a small cardiac vein runs first with the right marginal artery and then with the right coronary artery in the coronary sulcus. And then there is the left posterior ventricular vein that drains in the diaphragmatic surface. And that is that vein right here.